Tom here from Warren Systems, and we are finishing up a job, but I'm making this the beginning of the video because, boy, did this not go... I mean, it went well. It just took a little bit longer than expected. I wanted to talk about how we do rack wiring. This is a project we're finishing up for a client. You kind of see all the stuff behind me. That looks like a kitchen. This is going to be a sales area. We'll kind of walk through here. But fun projects. It's nice, high-end. We want to do a nice job on a wiring rack, so we've been... rewiring anything and having fun. But now let's get into the video.
Now, when I say the project didn't quite go as planned, what I'm really referring to is this building was purchased in 2019 by our client. We started the project in February of 2020. Then everything kind of decided to be put on pause due to the events of 2020 that kind of bled into 2021. So didn't go as a plan, just like how 2021 and 2020 really didn't go as planned. Now, when we did this project and started it versus when we finished it, one of the other changes were, well, changes that were made because when you have a year and a half to think about what you would do differently in terms of how the client may have laid things out, a couple of extra drops, a couple extra changes. This led to a bundle of cables being run first and a bundle of cables being run second, and that bundle being, well, a little bit different because it was a little bit longer because we were going to put it the rack over there and now the rack's over here. So those are a couple of minor changes I thought I would address. When it comes to all the parts and tools we use, I have those linked down below. This is just a really consistently popular question of what tools did you use and is the Klein screwdriver the best one? Well, let me answer that question really simple. I know people are super passionate about what tools they choose to use, and it is not like it's a binary decision because I'm holding a Klein screwdriver. I hate every other brand of screwdriver. Sometimes I buy what's on sale as long as it's a good tool. So my choices are choices we made based on things that were on sale that are also still a quality product. But yes, feel free to use whichever one you want, and they're perfectly fine to use competing brands. Weird polarization I get in comments and people asking questions about it, but nonetheless, we did use the contractors, I should say, do have the Milwaukee packouts. I do really like that as a setup. I think they've done a nice job, Milwaukee, putting it all together. I'll do a completely separate video in the future on that if there's enough comments down below asking for it. Everything else will be linked, of course, as I said, so you can find all the tools we use and even a few that were used previously in that rack build. And I'll leave a link to that video because I go a little bit more in depth than I will in this particular video. Now, when it comes to putting all the cabling in, we first are going to start with making sure it's supported properly. Please never install cables and just lay them everywhere on top of things. This is, sometimes it still happens, but if you have the choice and you're doing a nice new construction and you're not just dragging a cable across for a one drop and you can take the time and the budget's there to put it all together, great. This was done properly. We did use the J-hooks and bridle rings, and specifically the bridle rings we use have a series of plastic rings in them. This is to stop any type of problem you run into of radius bend. Not only radius bend, and when you're filling up any one of these, and whether it's a J-hook or bridle ring, generally a good rule of thumb and recommended by standards organization, just never fill them 40% of their capacity because wiring things only gets bigger over time. You may be only installing X wires today, and if you keep the capacity at 40%, that leaves you plenty of room to grow when you inevitably come back to that client because they decided you need 20 more runs added to things. And this is actually why we actually changed ones out, because they added more runs to this particular project than were originally spec'd in the original building. So it required us to go and split things up and put more suspension, more support tools in to finish the project. Now, once you have all that in there, bundling the cables together, please use lots of Velcro. Velcro makes your life easier and also makes this a very serviceable project on there. We took and put all the Velcro on, and then comes the looming of how we pull it into the rack. Now, when you're doing this, this particular job has roughly 40 some odd drops that were in there. So we actually get two 24 patch panels. Now, using a 24 on top and a 24 on the bottom and a 48 port switch in the middle is what gives you that cleaner look when you're using a series of such as these slim run cables right here and going back and forth. I really like the color coding ones. We just didn't have enough of the termination jacks to put in, these keystone jacks to terminate and put in that were color coded, because the client says, can you do it specifically this day so we can move up our opening date? We said yes and came in to meet their updated guidelines for getting it all done. That just didn't give us enough time to get enough of the color coded ones because we had used them all on a previous job. when you're pulling through the cable, and we've got some of this on video, but I didn't get a good job of them trimming it. So you pull all these through, and this is an important aspect when you want to keep everything nice and neat. Just like how when someone's cutting hair, you'll see them use a comb, pull the hairs all to in a straight, works much the same way. Now these, because I just crimped this real quick with, and I know I'm blasphemous, I use some zip ties, but that's because I'm throwing this away as soon as I'm done, and as you should with everything that uses zip ties. I will pull this out and it looks the same length because it is, but ideally they won't be the same length, but you want them to be the same length. So you go ahead and trim these all out and leave a little bit of slack. You don't have to leave that much when you pull these out. Then you pull them out this way, snap on all the ends, pull them back in there and go through. Now, one advantage of having a really big service loop is after you pull it through the rack, you're able to do things like sit in a chair and comfortably start snapping all these together. And then you work them back up and pull all the slack back out to snap them back in and make it easy. Part of the goal of this is never to do work that is more tedious or more time on your feet. You want to do things so you're not exhausting yourself doing this, because when you do this every day, day in and day out, I mean, you do get really proficient at it, you do get good at it, but you also can get a little bit burned out and you don't really want to do that. So finding ways to make yourself more comfortable, whichever way works for you, is definitely something to stop and take into consideration at. Once we do that, we start putting everything in, putting all the parts in. This is just a unified 48 port switch. And one aggravation I do have, and this goes across many, many switch brands, is when you don't have a 48 port switch, yes, you'll have to use some of these, and these are actually some longer slim run cables. We were lucky in this particular project that the switch ports line up with having one of these on top and one of these on bottom to make it nice. But yeah, that is a disadvantage if you have a 24 port and all the ports are on one half or one side of the switch. You'll end up with a little bit less neat of a job, but it's not always about neatness. It is about cleanly having it done so it's very easy to follow, very easy to see. It doesn't matter if a few of them are off to the side here. It really matters about serviceability. That's huge in terms of, can I easily see the wires, easily understand from what port they're going to what patch number they're going to, or whatever labels I have on the patch panels. Speaking of labels, yes, as we go through and we make sure all of these are labeled, the labels on the patch panels always have to match the labels on the wall plates. So as you go through and make sure you put all of these on, then we go around to the different spots inside the client and make sure all those match. This is just a sanity thing, so we know which patch panel had which number on there, and we print all the labels. And of course, the label printer we use will be linked down below. It's just a Brother P-Touch label printer. But hopefully this is a little bit of a clarification. It's a rather short video, but just kind of get you an idea. I'm working on some longer, more in-depth project videos to show exactly how some of this work is done in more detail. I'm not always sure what people want to see, so leave some comments down below to help me understand of how I can bring this to you better and what is the aspect of this job that would be most interesting to you. All right, and thanks. And thank you for making it all the way to the end of this video. If you've enjoyed the content, please give us a thumbs up. If you would like to see more content from this channel, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon. If you'd like to hire a short project, head over to lawrencesystems.com and click the Hire Us button right at the top. To help this channel out in other ways, there's a join button here for YouTube and a Patreon page where your support is greatly appreciated. For deals, discounts, and offers, check out our affiliate links in the description of all of our videos, including a link to our shirt store where we have a wide variety of shirts that we sell, and designs come out, well, randomly, so check back frequently. And finally, our forums. Forums.lawrencesystems.com is where you can have a more in-depth discussion about this video and other tech topics covered on this channel. Thanks again for watching and look forward to hearing from you.
You know, they say, Steve's doing the most important part of the job. You know, Steve and Alex, you gotta sweep up your shit, right?
Yeah.
The rack looks really nice too. Yeah, but the rack looks really nice too.
You said a bad word.
I don't care. It's midnight. I mean, how long were we doing this, Ali?
Too long.
It's too long. Well, that's life. Too long. Ha ha ha.